Yeah, we have started the recording. Okay, wonderful. So it'll be good if somebody can please pray, invite the Holy Spirit to lead us, and we will get started with what we have to talk about today. How about Sidkenu? Can you please lead us in prayer today?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, sure.
Father God, we come to the throne of grace. Lord, we thank that all the students have come into the class. Lord, whatever we will learn in this class, Lord, that should be abide in our heart and we should practice in our daily life, Lord. We pray no mishappening should be done in the class, Lord. We pray for the Wi-Fi network. We pray for the older students' connectivity. We pray for the recording, Lord. We pray for the students who will be joining with us in the e-learning portal, Lord. We thank you for all the system you have made available to us, Lord. In the days to come, Lord, we might be used as the vessel, as a strong vessel to be for the Lord's kingdom glory. We pray that whatever we will learn, Lord, whatever you have stored in our heart, Lord, whatever the ma'am will teach us, Lord, we pray for her, we pray for our students, we pray for our fellow classmates, Lord, we pray for APC Bible School, Lord. You have given us this opportunity, Lord. May you enable us, Lord, to use this opportunity as far as possible, Lord. We thank you for each and everything, and we thank you for each and everything on goodwill, Lord, you have done to us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you. Thank you, Sidkenu. Wonderful. Thank you for leading us. Thank you for praying for the class and for everybody. And I'm sure we are blessed to start off with that prayer. So today we will get into learning about, personal prayer life. Some basics about prayer and what prayer is, how to communicate with God, what are some of the right foundations to have, and different kinds of prayers. We also touched on the prayer in the spirit, okay, which is so important in the last class. So I think I said that we would start off with some questions. If all you have praying in tongues, we then continue into the rest of today's class. So anyone, you want to clarify something or add to what has been discussed, you can do that. Okay, seems like things are quite clear. So that's all right. We will proceed then. So now, by learning about praying in the spirit and learning about the pattern of prayer, which we said, you could use different patterns, but the Lord Jesus taught us the Lord's Prayer. So, that pattern can be incorporated in our prayer life. So we're going to learn more things to develop our own prayer life. So I want us to from the beginning, yes, but more so from now, see how we can incorporate, right, these things into our own personal lives. Okay, like today this particular topic is very much concerning our daily prayer walk with the Lord. So we will keep on developing that prayer walk. Okay, so there are different aspects that we will talk about. Now, our prayer life. Okay, it can constitute, one is our personal prayer life, and the other one is a corporate prayer life. Okay, personal would be how we communicate with God when we are alone, and corporate is when we communicate with God as a congregation or as a group of people, as a family, or as a team. So that is corporate. We use the term corporate to say group prayer. In the early church, we see that. We see individually people are calling out to God. We also see together in one accord, they call out to God. So prayer is both these kinds of prayers are what we generally engage in. So when it comes to our personal prayer life, we can develop it in a very, very strong way And this is something that needs to be done intentionally. Because if you are not intentional about it, then things that we are casual about, we generally never tend to develop it. Like, for example, if you ask any musician I think my battery is kind of draining. So if at all I get disconnected, I will join in from my phone. Okay, I'm not able to admit people also. Okay, anyway. So with the example of a musician, what I was trying to say is that we practice goals and we hope that we will learn and we will pick up new skills. We will become smoother playing and or singing. So even that kind of effort goes in intentionally. And similarly, even a sports person will tell you that if at all they want to achieve something in that area, they aside and they are intentional about it. And the same thing applies to our spiritual walk. If we are casual about anything, then sooner or later, you know, it will just fizzle out. When it comes to prayer, we cannot afford to do that. We have to be intentional about it. So we must, you know, take time to prayer and be well closely regimented or be disciplined about it. So in 1 Corinthians 9 verses 24 through 27, Paul says, we are temperate, okay, in all things because we are running to win a heavenly reward. So he says temperate is to exercise self-restraint or be kind of, you know, regimented, or you regulate it or you closely control it. Because it's important to you. So unless you put in that kind of an effort and you are intentional, you can't really see in that area. So similarly, when it comes to our prayer life, it's good to be disciplined. Okay? So the point that I'm coming to is being disciplined when it comes to our personal prayer life. Now, if you look at the Word of God, you see someone like Daniel. Okay. We know that he got into a tight situation when they said not pray to any other god, there was a decree that was passed out. But then, you know, you find that in the midst of something as difficult as that, Daniel still, right, goes and prays. He looks in that direction where of the temple and he prays as he always used to. So there is something said about Daniel in Daniel chapter 6 and verse 10. It says, "Now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went home, and in his upper room with his windows open toward Jerusalem, he knelt down on his knees three times that day and prayed and gave thanks before, as was his custom since early days." Okay, so that part there tells us that Daniel did not respond to a difficulty. What was the challenge at that time? There was a decree and Daniel could not obey it because he was a follower of God, and he knew that he might get caught for praying to, you know, the true and living God and facing the direction of the temple, but he still went ahead and did it. Did he do it only on that day as a reaction, as a response? No. But we are told here, as was his custom since early days. So he had a practice of praying, and it clearly says here, on his knees, he worked. So he was closely regimenting his prayer times. He knew when he's going to pray, he knew, you know, how he's going to pray, where he, like that. So we notice here that having a place to pray, you know, a time to pray, and a rhythm, you know, is always very, very helpful. Now, when we talk about having a rhythm and being able to pray in this manner, I'm sure people, all of us, you know, can come up with excuses. So The common, I wouldn't call it an excuse, but the mindset sometimes we can have is that we say, okay, led by the spirit. So whenever I feel like it, okay. So the problem with that is, you know, when we do that, when we don't have a set time and a set, set time, set place, and an intention to pray, it seldom happens. So if you notice, if we go by this mindset, I will pray whenever I can pray and all. If you sit and write out, how many times did you actually pray that week? It'll be very few times, or maybe, because you're waiting for the leading of the spirit to actually do it. Okay, so this kind of a mindset can prevent us from being consistent in our, then an excuse that people can have is, I pray as I go through the day, so I don't really have to set any aside. See, again, when we this, right, and we say, yeah, I'll just pray whenever I can, it may not happen. Okay, that's the danger of it. So it's better to have that, you know, dedicated time to pray. Then some people might say, I'd rather work than pray, right? Because you know, there's that saying that goes, what healing hands are better than praying lips, or something like that. Service overrides good intention. Yeah, that is understandable, but who are part of the kingdom of God, we who are God's, understand that prayer is very, very important, right, in our relationship with God and in the exercise of our spiritual authority. So prayer is communication, but it's also spiritual warfare. It's so many things for us. So we cannot have one in place of the other. So just praying and not working, it's not how believers are called to live their lives, because we have to do both. You know, your faith without works is what James says. So prayer and our service must go hand in hand. But when we say things like, I'd rather work than pray, you know, that's not correct. That's not correct. Then we could also say things like, I don't have enough time to pray. Now, you know, this thing of not having enough time, frankly, when we consider life, and anybody, all of you, I'm sure, will agree with me, as you keep moving forward in life, right, from when you're in school, you think, okay, you know, we can have a lot of excuses and even say things like, I don't have the time. But what I was pointing to is, you know, life only keeps getting busier. Okay. Yeah, thanks, Divya. Even I'm glad I'm back in the class. So life only gets, you know, busier and busier. So if we don't set aside time for it, then it'll never really happen. Okay. So So we must make sure that we keep time for prayer. Okay. All right. So let me just go further over here. So we talked about the excuses which we can make. Now, even in the life of Jesus, you know, obviously, Jesus was somebody who made time for prayer. And we've seen some scriptures when we talked about Jesus being the example. We said that he woke up early morning to pray. Went away from the crowds so that he could go up to a mountain and pray. So he set aside time just to make sure that, you know, he had fellowship with the Father, and he prayed through many things. Even before he selected his disciples, we are told, right? The whole night he actually prayed, okay? And only then in the morning he went and he chose his disciples. So Jesus dedicated time to pray. And you see, the disciples, when they wanted to ask Jesus a question, teach us to do this, teach us to do that, yes, they could have initially asked the question, teach us to do the miracles and all. Later on, they asked him those questions. But what is one of the first few questions recorded by the you know, the writers of the Gospels? Teach us to pray. When Jesus was asked, okay, teach us how to pray, That's when Jesus said, okay, pray like this, our Father who art in heaven. So obviously, Jesus had a prayer life, which was observable by the disciples. And he set aside time, you know, early morning, they wouldn't find him with them. So they would need to go look for Jesus because he would have gone praying. So he had a very disciplined prayer life, just like Daniel. And are we to say that both Jesus and Daniel were not busy? Yes, they were very busy. Jesus' ministry, we know how he served. We know Daniel, he was a man in the courts of, you know, the king. And he had a huge responsibility on his shoulders, being an official of that ranking and influence. And yet, everyone knew that Daniel was a man of prayer, that he would take time to pray. So, it's good to have a time which is set aside for us to go and pray. Okay, so here are some guidelines which I'm going to share with you, which will help us to develop our own personal prayer lives. Okay, now this is again not to make us feel like, you know, if you don't do this, then it's bad. No, none of that. That's why we are using the term develop. So if you're not the kind who has a disciplined way of praying, then you can grow in it, right? I can grow in it. So that's the whole point. So what are some of these guidelines? Okay. So please don't take it like the 10 commandments or anything like that. So the first thing is to maintain a set time and a place to pray. Okay. Otherwise, what happens, you know, we get caught up in a lot of other things. Like generally for me, it's like the early morning times before work starts off. That's the most peaceful time to actually, you know, read the Bible, reflect, meditate on God's word, spend some time to pray, right? And also, you know, to have a set place. So, you know, I kind of prefer to sit in a particular place. So that way, at least I know that, you know, I won't get distracted. I know what I'm doing there. Sometimes I just prefer to maybe have some hot water or something in the morning to just kind of wake myself up. And then I know that I'm sitting here to read the Bible. I'm sitting here to pray. I'm sitting here to pray about these things. So once I'm through with that, okay, let me just move on to other things. So you can have a set time and a set place to pray. Now, what if, you know, you don't have a set place? These are all things that help you, right? Like if you just say, oh, okay, I'll just sit on my bed and pray. You know what happens, right? Most of us, you just might end up going back to sleep. So it is helpful to have a set time and a set place. Now, we know that not always, you know, we can keep up that time. Maybe on a particular day you're traveling, or there is some emergency at home, and you know, you're probably staying in the hospital, something happens. So the point is that yes, we may have days where we don't follow the set time and set place, but whenever we are back to normal, you know, we go back to our routine. Okay, and that really helps. So it's not to be rigid, but you can have that element of flexibility for certain days where you might miss it. You were sick or something, right? Or something else is happening. You have an exam and you couldn't keep the time for prayer. Doesn't matter. Then the next day, you just try to come back to it. So have a set time, have a set place. And it's also helpful to have a format. So we talked about the pattern of the Lord's Prayer. So that is something you can incorporate. Or you, in addition to that, you can incorporate a couple of other, you know, sections in your prayer time. So you begin with thanksgiving, spend some time, you know, praising God, honoring God and all that. Okay. And then you move on. You move on from there. You could spend some time confessing, right? Confessing you know, if there's anything that the Holy Spirit is actually convicting you about. So please give me a moment here. My notes has disappeared. Yeah, I'm back with my notes. So you can spend some time just searching your heart, confessing any sins that the Holy Spirit is convicting us about. And in this moment, basically, you know how Jesus said in the Lord's Prayer that forgive forgive our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. So when we come in prayer, we must be clear with our relationships. So you set all those things right before the Lord. So earthly relationships, it could be family relationships, it could be work relationships, church relationships. So we ensure that we are walking right before God. Okay, so you spend some time praying these prayers of searching and confession and forgiveness. We could every now and then we can come back to praise and worship with the Lord. We could also spend some time just waiting on the Lord. So waiting on the Lord is to just be in His presence. While we are in His presence, we know like even Isaiah 40:31, it says that God will strengthen us. They that wait upon the Lord shall mount up with wings as eagles. They will run and not go weary. They will walk and they will not faint. So basically we are taking time, right, in God's presence to be strengthened and encouraged by His Spirit. Then we might go on, to go on to cover other things. So I'm just sharing what is there in our notes right now, but you can use any which pattern that you feel led to. So praying for our personal spiritual life. So in this, what would you pray? You would pray to be strengthened by God, right? You would be strengthened, pray that God, you strengthen me in my inner man, Lord, that I would know you more deeply, that I would walk closer to you, that I would see the manifestation of the work of the Spirit in my life. Then, would pray for victory, right? In every area of your life, especially in your spiritual life, pray for deliverance from any work or scheme of the evil one. So just cover all the points that may concern your spiritual life. Now, you may also want to pray and declare things like, God, help me to walk in the call of God upon my life, increase the anointing of God upon my life, lead me with your understanding and with your wisdom. Right, so you might pray all such prayers, and then you can go on to praying for your own family members. So you might want to pray for your spouse, pray for your children, and you may pray the same prayers like wisdom, anointing, strength, right, and especially the spiritual walk, that they may walk in the call of God for their lives, and they may overcome every work of the evil one, and so on and so forth. So you pray for your spiritual life. And then we may want to spend some time interceding for others. So in the intercession part, we may pray for our church, we may pray for our cell group, we may pray for some loved ones, those who have given us prayer requests, praying for healing, praying for some difficulty which they are going through, or anything. There can be so many things that we want to pray for others. So we pray for the needs of others. Now, after having prayed for others, we could spend some time praying for our own personal needs, because that's what Jesus taught us, right? He said that, give us this day our daily bread. So we pray for all our needs, okay, and bring that before the Lord. Now, this is like a rough pattern which you can have with the Lord's Prayer, and including a lot of other subsections here, and that way we can cover the prayer. So why to have a pattern? Because even at times when you feel tired or you feel like, I don't think I really want to pray, at least you know, oh, okay, I have all these needs, and I have to pray for all these people, and I have to regularly pray for myself in these areas. So you have something to begin with. Okay, and you go into a time of prayer, and another good thing is that you can cover most of the needs and requirements. So having a pattern, having a list is definitely helpful. But I already told us that this is not meant to box you in to a particular pattern, but please be led by the Spirit. But it definitely helps. Okay. Now, we also know that, we can take some time engaging in spiritual warfare. And by that you mean, you pull down strongholds, you pray against the work of the enemy and all of that. So you could do that as well. Now, since we are talking about scheduled times, it doesn't mean that we cannot pray at other times. Okay, now Daniel prayed three times. So does it mean that I can only set aside time, you know, maybe in the morning or evening and just pray that time? I should not pray any other time. It's not like that. We can have a combination of scheduled as well as spontaneous times of prayer, because God's word teaches us, 1 Thessalonians 5 verses 16 through 18. Now we read there that we must pray without ceasing. Okay, and I think I mentioned about the Holy Spirit, koinonia, fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And that is not something that we can box into time schedule. So at all times, we are invited to pray, but we must also have disciplined, scheduled, regimented times during the day to pray, because it will help us connect regularly with God. Okay, so also have spontaneous times and know the value of praying without ceasing. Then, apart from that, you know, you may want to have times where you spend an entire day. Now, this happens in our lives. You know, you just decide that, okay, this weekend, you know, I have all these things on my heart and I really want to spend time with God. So in addition to our daily prayer times, in addition to, you know, fellowshipping with the Holy Spirit in a continuous kind of a way, you might think that, okay, let me set aside, you know, Friday, Saturday, or if you don't have anything much happening on Sunday, maybe even Sunday, you decide, okay, I am going to keep these 2 days aside, just fast, pray, seek God's face. So you can have some special days of prayer as well. Now, when you study about the lives of people like Daniel, he did that whenever he needed to understand a truth or a vision, a revelation, he would just go into prayer. So have times of prayer, days of prayer. So that is something we can also look at. And there can be prayer seasons, right? So prayer seasons would mean like, I'm sure, you know, we've experienced 21 days of prayer, 40 days of prayer. We pick out a season in our lives where we say, okay, I'm going to dedicate myself to prayer schedule prayer through this season, and you can have any motive for that. I want to draw closer to God, or I'm trusting God for a breakthrough, or I need God's direction right in my life. It can be anything. So you basically set aside that season and you seek after God. Okay, so these are all ways to engage in prayer. Now when we do this, we are able to develop our relationship with God and also to strengthen our spirit man. Okay, so far, what have we said? We've said that we can have dedicated times of prayer as well as spontaneous times of prayer, and both of this will enrich our prayer life. So how is this going to enrich our prayer lives? It will help us develop intimacy with God, so we can grow deeper in our relationship with God. And when we are praying, right, our will gets aligned to the will of God. Now, when we talked about the prayer of believing, receiving an answer from God, we discuss so much about, hey, what is God's will? What if I don't know God's will? You know, sometimes when you take up a point and you're praying about it over a period of time, even when you think differently, right, what happens? As you're studying the word, your will becomes aligned to the will of God and you're ready to say, okay, God, yes, I surrender. So when we are spending time in prayer consistently, our will be aligned to the will of God. We can also be renewed, right? We can be renewed in our spirit through prayer. And it can obviously help us to refresh ourselves and strengthen ourselves in the presence of God. So these are all the benefits of praying in setting aside time to pray. And in addition to that, you know, we can experience a growing inner cleansing. Okay, so by that we mean that, you know, when we are in God's presence, when we let the Holy Spirit work in us, the Word of God work in us, the way David cried out, you know, he said, Lord, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. So there is a cleansing that takes place, right? When we are spending time with the Lord, and you know, at the depths of our heart, we are letting God search. We are waiting. It could be the kind of prayer that we said, you know, waiting on the Lord. When we are waiting on the Lord, or we are soaking in the presence of the Lord, what happens? The Spirit of God can work deep in us. And the psalmist also said, like, search me, O God, know my heart, try me, know my anxieties. So Holy Spirit can work deep within us, you know if there's any wicked way in me. So He can cleanse us and He can lead us from there on. So all this can take place in prayer. And that is why we must make sure that we set aside time for prayer. And prayer is a place where the cleansing can also take place, the renewal can take place, God can minister ideas to us. So when we started off, we said that, you know, prayer is two-way communication. It's not just bringing our requests and just giving it off to God, but also for God to be able to speak back to us. So in our moments of prayer, as we are speaking, you know, petitioning, bringing our supplication, thanksgiving, we also have moments where we just wait on what is it that God wants to say. Okay. And in Habakkuk, there is a scripture, Habakkuk 2 and verse 1, which says, I will stand my watch and set myself on the rampart and watch to see what He will say to me. So what Habakkuk is saying is watching and waiting to hear from God. Yes, I have made my point, but God, what do You want to say? So you wait and you listen, right? So there are times in prayer, moments in prayer where, you know, you're just waiting on the Lord, and suddenly, you know, God tells you, hey, this is what I want you to do, or this is the door I'm opening for you, or, you know, how about you try this new idea in your ministry or in your business? So God is also speaking to us. God is communicating back to us, right? But we are waiting, we are watching. Yeah, we put across something to God. What does God want to say? And sometimes it may not even be a petition that we made in prayer. But as we are in the presence of God, as we are praying, God may decide that I want to give this particular idea to this individual. So we might receive ideas, thoughts, instruction, right, from God in prayer. That is one step. But of course, we have to implement it. We have to work, you know, with that idea and then make it happen. So that's another ball game altogether. But God ministers to us. When we wait, we watch, even when we don't know what we are supposed to do, God can speak back to us. So we receive from God. So all this can happen, right, in our prayer times. Now imagine if I don't have a prayer time, I'm missing out on everything. I'm missing out on speaking to God. I'm missing out on bringing my requests. I'm missing out on aligning my will. I'm missing out on the cleansing that can happen in my life every day, right? I'm missing out on the renewal that I can experience, that stress. Sometimes we say, right, stress, I'm stressed. But if we have regular times of prayer, you know, that's a place where surely we can exchange our burdens for God's peace. We can cast our cares on the Lord. We can receive that renewing, right, that we've been talking about. And also God's leading. So every day God guides us about our family, about our ministry, about, you know, our finances. So every day that communication we can establish with God. And in this manner, if we can develop, you know, this pattern where every day we maintain that prayer time, and in addition to that, you know, our spontaneous times, some days of prayer, some seasons of prayer, you know, then it will really build us up in our relationship with God. Now, the second aspect is corporate prayer. We will talk more in depth about corporate prayer later, developing our prayer life in that manner. But the basic point we want to make right now is that the corporate prayer life is only as strong as the individual prayer lives of the people. Okay, so if we all can develop strong prayer lives, then, you know, you imagine the strength of the corporate prayer that we can have. So that's all the key themes from our topic here. Oops. Sorry, everyone. I don't know what happened. Okay, yeah, sorry everyone, I just happened to press something else. So those are some of the key things that we have looked at. And I leave this time open if you have any questions or, you know, you just want to discuss on any subject. So please feel free. You could share your questions. If possible, if you can unmute yourselves and ask, that is better, because if I press something else, I don't know if I'll get disconnected again. So, any questions on scheduled prayer times?
Thank you, Pastor Nancy, for
no problem.
Yeah, and I was just thinking about the last session, praying in the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So over the last week, I was able to, you know, practice some of those things we learned. And yeah,
amazing.
Yeah, it's really helpful. Thanks for sharing those. And one thing is, how can we like develop, you know, even more praying in the spirit?
Mm.
I was thinking about
that. Sure, Divya. So in this, what we have discussed, right, you're scheduling your prayer time and then you can use a pattern. You can also incorporate praying in the spirit. In fact, it's there in your notes where you can have one section of your prayer time just to pray in tongues. So you could practice it that way.
Okay, yeah. Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you.
So anything else you wanted to check about, Divya, or does that answer your question?
I was also thinking of when we need guidance or direction about something, and we are praying in the spirit. You have mentioned that we sometimes God might help us interpret what we prayed, right? The
yes,
mysteries and all that.
Yes.
Yeah. So, I just wanted to, if you have any testimony or something.
Oh, testimonies. Okay. About praying in the spirit, is it? Praying in the spirit and interpreting it?
Yeah. Or something that you've heard of. This was coming to me always, like I'm not able to understand what I'm saying, right? So sometimes,
yeah, correct.
Oh, am I making it up? Like, you know, sometimes you can have doubts regarding, right? Yeah,
correct. Yeah. Yeah, sure, Divya. So see, one thing is we have to accept that when we pray in the spirit, we can't understand it. The scriptures that we pointed out, you know, 1 Corinthians 4:2, we speak mysteries unto God, and then 1 Corinthians, 14:2, and then 1 Corinthians 14 verses 14 and 15, where Paul says, I pray with my understanding, I pray with my spirit. So understanding is different from praying in the spirit. So you can't understand it. You know, we have to just come to terms with that. So every time I pray in tongues, if I want to understand what I'm saying, again, it may not happen. Okay. But we can seek interpretation of it, and sometimes I said that the interpretation of that prayer can be deposited in our spirits, and we can come to know what exactly we have prayed for. If you ask testimonies, there are so many testimonies actually of people. It's not really like interpretation or anything, but I remember like in one of our conferences, one of our pastors, they were sharing how, when they spent time with God, they prayed in the spirit. It was not immediately after they had prayed, but just suddenly, like the word of what they had to preach, right? One particular sermon, the entire sermon came into their spirit. Okay. And it doesn't happen always. It doesn't really happen always, but sometimes things like this happen. So they got the entire sermon and they preached the sermon for the first time without any notes. And it was so good that went back and wrote it up.
Okay.
Right? And released it.
Okay.
So... yeah, the first time the person preached is the first time the person even like heard it.
Yes.
Because it came straight into the spirit.
Wow.
So these are all like supernatural things that happen when you depend on the Holy Spirit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hope your last week's session went well. You were telling about...
Oh, something. Yes. It did. It went really well. Yeah, thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, Pastor. Yeah, it helps.
Yes.
Please
so things like that happen. Yeah.
Please continue praying for us that we may practice these, like what we are learning. Yeah.
Sure, Divya. Sure. And the thing about praying in the spirit is it's like practicing a human language. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So some of us may not feel very comfortable initially. And we might only, even in the words that we are saying, we might feel that, hey, I'm just repeating.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But don't let that discourage you. Because remember, I said every syllable is a perfect prayer, because we know the Spirit helps us to pray in the will of God.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. So tell yourself that, okay, don't worry too much about, what words... or what sentences I'm making, but every syllable which is coming out of my mouth, even if it is repetitive, I am praying in the perfect will of God. So it is a perfect prayer.
Yeah. Sure. That really helps. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you, Divya. Yes, I can see Nicholson has a question there. Yeah.
Hi, Pastor Nancy. I just want to know some practical advice on, I know that you were working and ministering at one point.
Oh, yeah.
So
correct.
Right now I'm in that phase, and it I think it's really crazy to manage both. So I've tried everything possible, morning, afternoon, evening, whatever, like trying to schedule. But if you could give any practical advice on how you manage that and what worked for you, that would be great.
Yes. Sure, Nicholson. Thank you. It's a great question. To be very honest, I was not that consistent, I should tell you, with the timings, because my timings at the time when I was working, it would go, all over the place. So some days it would be morning, some days it would be in the evening when I am able to concentrate. What I'm teaching you here about developing, I think I have done that over time, and now it's more regular, and it's mostly mornings that I get to spend time with God. But what I would say about my work times is that to be intentional about it. Like I remember I would try to write down my plan and say, okay, I need to get time with God. This will be my prayer time. So you plan it up, because unless you plan it, you will not make time in a day. It's very easy for prayer to just get pushed, out of your schedule, because everything else is important. Everything else is urgent. Okay, so just write it down and say that, you know, I am going to do it. So that's something I used to do. I used to make sure that, okay, even if it's not at a given time, I need to pray. I need to make time for prayer. And if I miss it, then yes, you know, the weekends were a really good time to catch up. So what I would do is, you know, I was not so much like into social life or anything, but I would just say no to a lot of things so I can be by myself. I can read the Bible. I can pray by myself. So basically you carve out time. And I used to do a lot of that when I was working. Usually weekends, I would just say, Lord, it's dedicated to you. And then just spend time with the Lord. So that's how I used to do it. But then now I've kind of developed a rhythm where it's generally the mornings that I take to, you know, set aside for study and all. Yeah, so I hope that helps.
Yeah, thank you. That helps.
Yeah, no problem. And don't feel guilty, Nicholson, if you do miss it or if you feel like, hey, I'm not keeping a rhythm. It's okay. You can develop it over time.
Sure, thank you.
Yeah, sure. Thanks. Right. So, any other questions before we close today?
How long, Pastor?
Okay. How long meaning prayer, prayer time?
Yes, Pastor. How, I mean, usually okay. How long?
Usually how long? So, I think something like an hour, John, that would be the average. But then, you know, it sometimes it's way longer, sometimes it's a little lesser.
Are you?
Okay, Vasa.
Yeah. Sure. Okay. So, yeah, I think we have touched. Okay. So, Sitkanu says, I believe in flowing in the spirit. Sitkanu, if you don't mind, can you say it? Because I, on the phone, I'm concerned to touch anything, to not get.
Actually, ma'am, Brother John Paul was asking how much the duration should be of time. So what I was saying that it should be on the flowing in the spirit, then the Holy Spirit will lead like that.
Correct. So that's fine, Sitkinu, but what we are saying is if you have a like a set time, no? It's helpful. You at least cover the points every time. And then with that as your, I don't know what word to use, but that could be your minimum. Okay. And then some days can be more, some days can be less, but at least you make sure that you cover all your, you know, requests, waiting on the Lord, thanksgiving and all that. Sure. Okay. All right. So I think we can close off for today. And I really want to thank all of you. I'm sorry about the battery drain. Sorry for any inconvenience that you had to face because of this. I would like to request someone to please pray before we close today. Anyone?
Can I pray?
Yes, Lubeka, please go ahead.
Father in heaven, we thank you for today and for the lessons that we've had today. Father, we thank you that we did really understand and we're still continuing to understand the real source and how to pray and all other things as far as prayer is concerned. Lord, we thank everybody who has been here to get more insight about prayer. Lord, again, we thank our pastor who is also taking her dear time to teach us all what it takes to pray. Because, Lord, the Bible says that if my people lack because of lack of knowledge. So since God, we're getting how to know how to pray, maybe this time around we shall be able to touch and reach the throne of mercy. We do pray that when we meet again, we shall all be in peace. I pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And everybody says, Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Lubega. Thank you, everyone, for joining. God bless you. Have a great day. And we will meet again tomorrow. Okay. So bye. Bye for now. Take care. Bye. Thank you. Thank you.